long ago, deep in the forest, there was a hidden village where tiny creatures lived. They called themselves Smurfs. They were good. Then there was Gargamel, the evil wizard. He was bad.
Ooh, I hate Smurfs! I'll get you. I'll get all of you if it's the last thing I ever do. I'll get you. I'll find your village someday. You'll be sorry.
Well, the forest is still there. And if you listen, you may hear Gargamel's rage. And if you are good, you may just catch a glimpse of the Smurfs.
Perfect Smurf catcher. Now to try it out. Aha! It works! My footprint finding potion works! Strong, but this should fix it. After all, there's nothing worse than Smurfs who are overdone.
Smurfly not. Now put it back where you found it.
See? I told you Papa Smurf should see it first, but oh no, you wouldn't.
Oh, but Papa Smurf, he's so little.
Little fuzzles are big trouble. Put it back.
Yes, Papa Smurf.
All right, Smurfs, load up the logs. We're heading home.
Huh? Sorry, little fuzzle. Guess this is goodbye. You gotta keep your Smurf shut or this'll never work.
Aha! Smurf Prince! It won't be long now, Azrael. Where could that little wretch have gone? Aha! Come down from there, you little blue tree toad!
We'll get started on the repairs.
Well, little Fuzzle, I bet you're hungry. Gotta get back to work. Bye!
But it's lunchtime, and lunchtime is not for problems. It's for eating. See? Like they're doing. So? Yikes! My house! Where did these puzzles come from?
My house.
Papa Smurf was right. Puzzles mean big trouble, and he'll really be Smurf when he finds out you disobeyed him, Clumsy.
Oh, he sure will. What'll I do?
I don't know, but you better do it fast. Look.
Yes! Papa Smurf's lab. Hi, Papa Smurf.
Something wrong, Clumsy?
Wrong? More soup, Papa Smurf? Or maybe some dessert? Better yet, Papa, there's nothing like a brisk walk after lunch.
But I haven't eaten lunch yet. Now, what's going on here, Clumsy? Fuzzles! Clumsy! I warned you, Fuzzles were trouble.
I know, Papa Smurf, and I'm sure sorry.
They're destroying my lab. Round up every last Fuzzle and take them all back to the forest. Now.
Yes, Papa Smurf?
We're getting closer, Asbriel. I can feel it. There. What did I tell you? Smurfs were here. The sawdust is still fresh. It won't be long now.
Shoo, Fuzzle. Smurf off.
Mr. Scare-Em-Away. What? Here, Fuzzles, a present for you.
Well, that's all of them, Brainy.
Oh, it's about time. Let's Smurf them out of you like Papa Smurf said.
Peace and quiet at last.
Papa Smurf! Papa Smurf! Quick! The Fuzzles are heading for the dam!
What?
Make way for Papa Smurf!
Keep your fingers, Smurf. Gather all the Fuzzles before they wake up.
These little critters have the right idea.
Oh, no, Papa Smurf, they're waking up.
That's all of my sleeping potion, and there isn't time to Smurf up another batch.
Success! A genuine Smurf path. Those disgusting Smurfs have to pass here sooner or later. And when they do, we'll be ready.
Hey,
It's no use, Smurfs. There's nothing more we can do.
Guess it's cats for us. The end of Smurfdom as we know it.
It's all my fault.
Yeah, Harmony, that's terrible.
No, Harmony, keep playing louder.
Huh?
Oh, gosh, look! Faster, Harmony, they like your music.
They do? Hey, those fossils have taste! But, where do I take them?
Back to the woods where they belong.
Listen, here come the Smurfs with all their sickening, disgusting happiness. But we'll soon put a stop to that.
Yipes!
We have them, Asriel! We have the Smurfs! And judging from the weight, they're all here.
gosh, Papa Smurf, what's going to happen to those poor little fuzzles?
I'm not sure, Clumsy. Let's find out.
At long last, the Smurfs are ours. All ours. Yo! Back, I say! Get away from me, you little beasts! They've gone too far this time. I'll get those miserable, rotten Smurfs if it's the last thing I do!
Clementine! Oh. Hong Kong Phooey for I Scream Bottles.
That looked pretty painful, didn't it? Well, it was. But I've got a secret to hide the horrible screaming normally following a crash like
this. That's right, Hong Kong. And you can, too, thanks to I Scream Bottles. They'll take your pain away in a jiffy. And they come in three convenient sizes. Small. Medium. And large. So remember, when you're in pain, reach for an I Scream Bottle to take the pain away in a jiffy. And now available in extra large.
The city of Townsville is now on Boomerang! And so, once again, the day is saved thanks to the Powerpuff Girls. Weeknight to 10, only on Boomerang.
In the endless reaches of the universe, there once existed a planet known as Krypton, a planet that burned like a green star in the distant heavens. There, civilization was far advanced and had brought forth a race of supermen whose mental and physical powers were developed to the absolute peak of human perfection. But there came a day when giant quakes threatened to destroy Krypton forever. One of the planet's leading scientists, sensing the approach of doom, placed his infant son in a small rocket ship and sent it hurtling in the direction of the Earth just as Krypton exploded. The rocket ship sped through star-studded space, landing safely on Earth with its precious burden, Krypton's sole survivor. A passing motorist found the uninjured child and took it to an orphanage. As the years went by and the child grew to maturity, he found himself possessed of amazing physical powers. Faster than a speeding bullet, more powerful than a locomotive, able to leap tall buildings at a single bound.
Look, up in the sky!
It's a bird!
It's a plane! It's Superman!
This amazing stranger from the planet Krypton, the Man of Steel, Superman. Empowered with X-ray vision, possessing remarkable physical strength, Superman fights a never-ending battle for truth and justice, disguised as a mild-mannered newspaper reporter, Clark Kent.
To see you. Just received another threatening note.
Okay, Mr. White.
Lois, another note from the mad scientist.
Coming in, Chief.
Well, listen to this warning. He plans to strike tonight. Beware, you fools. My electrothanasia ray strikes tonight at 12. Total destruction will come to those who laughed at me and failed to heed my warning. Beware, I strike at midnight. This nut may prove dangerous. Kent, you help Lois follow up her lead. She may have an angle on this thing.
Yes, sir.
But, Chief, I'd like the chance to crack the story on my own.
Well, no.
Thanks, Chief.
But, Lois... Chief, don't you think that's a dangerous mission?
Thank you. matter for the...
Story. I'll give you the greatest story of destruction the world has ever known.
Looks like a job for Superman.
Congratulations, Lois. That was a great scoop.
Yes, Chief. Thanks to Superman.
Lois, what are you doing here?
Oh, just getting the woman's angle on this story.
The mechanical monster! Look out!
I'll give you the details later, Chief. All right, Lois. Lois! This is a job for Superman.
Story this is going to make.
The jewels. What have you done with the jewels?
You'll read about it in tomorrow's paper.
Are you going to tell me what happened to those jewels? She's doomed.
That's a wonderful story, Lois.
Thanks, Clark, but I owe it all to Superman.
Isn't that your car, Mr. Wexley?
Your instructor, Mr. Johnson, is not here today, but your substitute, Mr. Bixby, will be here any minute. It's about time you got here. Their assignment is on the table. Just keep them on task.
Careful. Don't you worry about a thing, Mr. Wexley. Finally. At ease, everybody. My name is Mr. Bixby, and I... pop quiz. What do you do when you see your van smoking?
First, I check the...
Great, do it. Show me. Now, the rest of you, write a 15-page paper about the history of German automobiles in German. Tell you what, the first person who can get me some blinker fluid from the auto store does not have to write the paper. Now I know who the smart ones are. Boys, let's make a deal.
So you're gonna give us each an A for the day, right, Mr. Bixby?
As long as you don't make it look stupid. I'm okay!
Mr. Bixby? Your van's ready. Here, let me get that out of your way.
Oh, Sheila! I thought I said, don't make it look stupid. Y'all can forget about those A's.
Mr. Bixby, we...
messed up my baby! Well, it's not that bad.
Bixby! What's going on here? Where are the other students?
I'll go get them.
Oh, wait, Mr. Bixby, we added...
I got this.
Cartoon Network.
What time is it? Adventure time!
We are the secret guardians of the books in the library.
Adventure time!
New episode and a new time.
Next Monday at 7:30, 6:30 Central, only on Cartoon Network.
Tom is a cat. Shifty, clever, reflexes like, well, a cat. This makes him the perfect opponent for any neighborhood or family dogs. And any mice who have taken up residence in his territory. Agile and resilient, he faces danger head on. Taking any matter of blows like a true competitor, be they golf balls to the teeth or ironing boards to the stomach. Jerry is a mouse. Resourceful, witty, and quick, he's nobody's fool. Jerry would rather use his charm and pleasant demeanor to gain allies or lure a feline foe into his trap. But if it must come to blows, Jerry is also quite handy with a branding iron or short piece of pipe. Now, see more of your favorites, Tom and Jerry, on Boomerang from Cartoon Network. It's all coming back to you.
And now, back to Pokemon on Boomerang from Cartoon Network. Pokemon will be right back here on Boomerang.
Maybe we better forget about Charles's wagon.
Chuck wagon, ding, chuck wagon, get with it. The spirit of the Old West, ding, is never give up.
It is, Hokey?
Put these feathers on, ding.
What's that for?
Just follow me, ding. This being Indian country, maybe he'll do business with Indians.
Boy, something sure smells good, Hokey.
I'll bake some mighty tasty pie, even if I do say so myself.
How, sir?
Huh?
How's about us make them trade?
What kind of trade, Injun?
We'll take your delicious homemade pie, for instance.
Okay, Injun. What about my delicious homemade pie?
Wouldn't you say it's worth a can of your homemade beans?
Sure it is.
Fine, sir, fine. Now, sir, isn't two cans of beans worth a sack of your flour?
I guess so.
Then I'll trade you this entire sack of flour for two measly pies.
You mean I'll get my flour and my beans for only two of my measly delicious homemade pies?
Right, sir, exactly. Ooh, you certainly drive a hard bargain, sir. Here's one for you, Dane.
I sure got the best of that, Injun. I'll have my beans and my flour back, and it only cost me two of my own pies.
Have some coffee with your pie, Ding-a-ling.
Swell, Hokey.
You consarned, conniving, no good wolves in sheep's clothing, drop them pies.
Now what do we do, Hokey?
Run a little faster, Ding Boy.
Special underwater mic. Who's gonna save the world? Who's gonna save the day? Who may have cracked his feeling eerie heels with you? Who's gonna talk like girlies and curly is in here? Who's gonna chase down villains and turn around and run his ears? You know who I'm talking about. He's fat and short of brains, and I am not in trouble. To tie you up in sailor's knots.
Who's gonna save the world? Who's gonna save the day? Who may have grabbed you stealing eerie heels with evil rain?
Who's gonna talk like girlies and curly ears in here? Who's gonna chase down villains and then turn around and run in fear? Who's gonna stand for justice when bad guys break the law? You know who I'm talking about. We're claiming chili and bubbles and fifth, but if you're catching a whiff of fish, you jabber jaw.
Popeye on Boomerang from Cartoon Network. It's all coming back to you.
And now, back to Pokemon on Boomerang from Cartoon Network.
Coming up next, it's Dexter's Laboratory on Boomerang.
And now, here's a special look at the new series, Level Up.
There's going to be a lot of stuff, a lot of really great leaks that come out from the game. There's a lot of screaming.
A lot of monsters.
I like your style, big guy.
A lot of skateboarding into walls.
The show sets you up for comedy with these really interesting characters.
There's a lot of action. There's a lot of sweet visual effects, too.
can blow a lot of stuff up.
Every week, we can all look forward to the moment where we all insult Connor.
Basically, in the show, I'll be eating various vegetables and junk food.
If you look at Level Up, you look at a show that's actually about kids who video game. You know, we all do it at night. We nerd out.
I'm a huge gamer.
I am a gamer. I'll play you.
We yell crazy things into our headsets.
Let's kick it.
Let's rock this thing, nerds.
Get ready to Level Up, the brand new series premiering Tuesday, January 24th at 8, 7 Central on Cartoon Network.
Provide our customers with the finest gems.
What are those?
Those carts hold the diamonds for our customers.
You only have two customers?
Of course not. See?
What a life that dog has.
Quite so, Irona. Nothing to do but float about in the pool all day.
So I said to the missus, I said, if I can't have Thursdays off, I'm quitting.
Good. You've got to learn to stand up for your rights, because...
Whee! You're so right, Mavis. She'll never find anyone as good as I am with that baby. What's the matter, baby Ken? Did that bad doggy frighten you? Shoo! Scat! Scram!
Hello,
Snookums, did the mean old doggy frighten you? You big bully, picking on a poor defenseless puppy.
Al, help! He robbed a bank. Somebody stop him. Somebody stop him!
They'll never catch me.
What?
Dogs! Phooey!
Good work, Simpson. Your quick thinking captured the bank robber.
Thank you, sir. I would have caught him sooner if that mutt hadn't gotten in the way.
$4. It is one of those days in which nothing goes right, eh?
In that case, perhaps this bone will cheer you up. Voila! Oh, what is the matter, mon ami? All is not lost. Voila!
Robot 97, that sort of thing is just not done in a proper household. Uh-oh. Now where am I going to put this last pile of leaves, huh? Whoops!
Hi, this is Richie Witch. Don't miss another action-packed zillion-dollar adventure coming up next.
Reggie's going to show us.
We'll soon find out. It's an educational film and it's ready to roll.
How do you like it so far?
A major motion picture by Reggie Vandoe.
Watch this bus. I put a few energy booster capsules in the gas tank.
That's not very funny, Reggie.
Oh, no? Wait till you see this. We interrupt this program to bring you a special bulletin. Hundreds of wild animals have just escaped from the zoo. They are extremely dangerous. Watch what happens when I play this jungle animal record. Strike!
Reggie, those stupid pranks aren't funny at all.
You call this film educational?
Sure, it'll re-educate me in case I ever forget how to pull pranks. Hey, look! A dollar folded in half!
That's him, the dark-haired one.
When I drop this smoke bomb, we grab him.
Richie, what's happening?
It's a smoke bomb. I'll activate my keen bean smoke eliminator.
Where's Reggie?
He's gone.
Hey, what's going on here?
A prankster like you can be very valuable to us.
Those men are taking Reggie away.
It's probably another one of his dumb jokes.
We'd better follow them, just to make sure.
There's the car, Richie!
There's some sort of insignia on it. The sign of the double cross. That comes from a small country called Obscuria.
It's all over for you guys. It's Richie Rich coming to rescue me.
This instant hair growing formula will take care of him.
Richie, the windshield is growing hair. We can't see.
No problem. The razor phaser will take care of it. There, that's better.
Uh-oh, but not for Dollar. Some of that hair-growing stuff must have splashed on him.
This instant ice will fix that brat for good.
The road has turned ice. I can't control the car. Hang on, everyone.
We're sinking. Do something, Richie.
This calls for the Keen Bean sub bubble. Don't worry, Dollar. You won't get wet in here.
Oh, no.
Now to activate the super flotation mechanism.
Oh, Richie, you're wonderful.
Hey, look at that. They put Reggie on that seaplane. I bet they're taking him to Obscuria.
Golly, what do we do now?
I've always wanted to visit Obscuria.
We've just got to catch up to them before something happens to Reggie.
No, Dollar, don't pull that cord!
Looks like Dollar could have flown there without the plane.
Okay, gang, we've made it to Obscuria. Now to find Reggie.
Maybe that man can help us.
Excuse me, sir. Can you take us to your ruler?
Ruler? Forget it.
These people sure scare easily.
Attention, citizens of Obscuria. Your ruler is about to make a speech.
Just the fellow we're looking for.
Here's your leader.
Boy, what a mean trick!
That must be how he keeps scaring the people.
Not to mention the animals.
We've got to find Reggie. Where are you guys taking me?
To our ruler.
Who is this?
We have brought you Reggie Van Dolph.
Ah, the famous prankster. Your tricks are most ingenious.
Thanks. Can I leave now?
Of course. As soon as you design the most evil prank ever seen to further frighten the people and keep them under my control.
I think a lot better at home.
You'll think better still in the dungeon. Take him away.
There it is. Headquarters.
I bet that's where they're holding Reggie.
But how do we get inside?
Looks like Dollar found something.
He found something, all right. Trouble.
So, the great Richie Rich has finally been outsmarted.
Richie, we've got to escape.
Not yet. First, I want to see what they're up to. So, you're the one who's holding Reggie prisoner.
That's right. Even now, he is dreaming up my most spectacular prank ever.
You'll never get away with this.
And who will stop me? And now, you may join your little friend.
Richie, Gloria, what are you doing here? We came to get you out.
How do you plan on doing that?
You'll see. It's exactly 4 o'clock.
Big deal. So what?
It's tea time. good old Cadbury. He's never late for tea time.
Okay, genius. So how do we get from down here to up there?
My micro-tracking magnet should do the trick. Okay, gang, let's get out of here.
Hey, you prisoners, stop! Huh?
Good show, Master Richard.
Lower the scooper net, Cadbury.
Tea, Master Richard?
Maybe later, but first we have to help the people of Obscuria. And Dollar, only your help.
This is your big plan? Painting Dollar green?
That's only part of it. Next, we have to fix up the blimp.
As soon as we recapture those brats, my reign of fear will truly begin.
What's that sound? A flying saucer?
Watch how this changes my voice.
We have come from outer space to free the people of Obscuria.
I'm getting out of here.
Me too.
Cowards! There are no such things as beings from outer space.
Oh, no? Here is our leader.
Wait for me!
That feather headdress really did the trick, Dollar.
That's no spaceman! It's Richie Rich's dog! Back to headquarters!
Richie, they're getting away! We'll see about that! Time for the little league lever!
Great catch, Richie! Ah, anybody could have done it with a glove that size!
People of Obscuria, you are free of your evil leader and free of fear!
Hooray for Richie Rich!
Thanks for shooting that film for us, Cadbury.
My pleasure, Master Richie. I love a happy ending.
Reggie, now that's what I call an educational film. Educational for you.
Here's what I think of your movie.
Help! Help, let me go!
Looks like Reggie's getting into the movies the hard way.
Get me out of here! Stop this thing! Call my agents!
Richie, I just love your new money museum.
It contains money from lots of different civilizations, Gloria. Like this caveman money made of bones. Forget it, Dollar. They're petrified.
What's this one, Richie?
That's conch shell money from the Goomby Islands. Put it to your ear.
You can hear a cash register.
And this is jumping bean money from Mexico.
Wow, how neat!
What was that noise?
It sounded like a truck.
Delivery for the Rich Money Museum.
What's that thing, Richie?
It's a coin from the Yap Islands.
Yap Islanders must have pretty big piggy banks.
No, Dollar, wait! I tried to warn you. It's made of stone. Now, help Gloria and me you check the outside security system.
The coast is clear.
Good. Now to rip off the rich money museum.
The dream of every self-respecting crook.
Everything's okay outside.
Uh-oh, they're coming back.
Quick, in here with the Eskimo money.
Okay, Dollar, let's put this up on the display shelf. No, Dollar, not that way. Dollar, are you all right? The coin's rolling away! Quick, after it!
I thought they'd never leave.
Come on, let's get the loot.
Gosh, Richie, that thing must be heavy.
Quick, back into the cooler.
As a matter of fact, it's lighter than it ought to be. No wonder, it's hollow. There's something funny going on here. Look there.
Money!
And it leads right to this refrigerated room.
It's Richie Rich.
Time to blow this joint.
Have some money on us.
Richie, I can't see.
That's the whole idea.
Don't catch a cold.
You're locked in. Do something, Richie.
Don't worry. I'll use my personally monogrammed laser phaser to get us out.
No safe is safe from Richie Rich.
Now to find those crooks and recover the museum money. The trail leads here to my miniature golf course. Where are the crooks?
Look, there they go.
Uh-oh, it's that rich brat.
Quick, let's make tracks.
They're getting away.
We'll follow them with my golf ball retriever. You might as well give back that money.
You gotta be kidding.
What do we do now, Richie?
Convert the submobile. Now to activate the golf ball retriever.
Looks like we gave him the slip.
That's what you think.
It's him again.
And here's another surprise.
Golf balls.
What a way to go. There they are.
They're getting away in that golf cart.
They won't get far.
We're stuck in this sand trap.
And here comes Richie Rich.
Do your stuff, Dollar.
Hey, cut it out.
Dollar, you're a regular King Tut.
Let's scram.
I'm with you.
We'll make our getaway on this mechanical camel.
How do you say giddy up and camel?
You push these levers.
Richie, they're getting away.
There's only one way to stop. Luckily, I brought along some of the jumping bean money.
He missed us.
Good shot, Richie.
Hey, what's going on?
It must have been something he ate.
Quick, hit the off button.
I can't, it just fell off.
We give up, Richie Rich.
Just get us down from here.
Okay, whatever you say. Dollar, I'll drive these crooks to jail while you gather up the jumping bean money.
Right.
The Mystery Ink Gang may look like a group of crazy kids and a dog who don't have a clue.
Hey, my glasses!
Or do they?
This earring resembles the one the gypsy fortune teller was wearing.
Torn up negatives. Somebody doesn't want somebody to see a picture of somebody.
Get a clue with Scooby-Doo.
Yo! I've been voodooed!
Now you can see more of Scooby-Doo on Boomerang from Cartoon Network. It's all coming back to you.
Wedgies! Cartoon Network.
Thank you.
Spider-Man.
Anyway,
I don't know. They say he used to be a Hollywood special effects man until an accident turned him into Mysterio.
Is it true? Is Spider-Man really gonna be here? Will I really see him?
Yes, my dear. You'll see a lot more tonight than you ever dreamed of.
Of minutes, my special celebrity guest will arrive, and my trap will be complete.
Somehow I feel like I'm walking right into a trap. A spider trap. But the TV already announced I'd make an appearance on the Mysterio Disco Hour show, so... Everything looks normal. But my spider sense is tingling like mad. If Mysterio's up to no good, maybe I can unmask him on his own show.
Look! It's really Spider-Man!
Ah, our special guest star has arrived. In honor of our wall-crawling friend, I have prepared a special tune. With a clever little touch of my own added in. My hypnotic beat added to the music, I now command an army of loyal followers. Feel honored, Webhead, you are the subject of my first command.
Listen to me. I am Mysterio. I am your leader. You will obey me. Spider-Man is our enemy. You must destroy our enemies. You must destroy Spider-Man.
Somehow I've got to save my own spider skin. Without hurting anyone. There's only one way out of this. Up! I've got to stop Mysterio now, before he gets too powerful. A little spider muscle should make short work of this door.
What's the matter, web brain? Losing your touch? That door is a special creation of my own, designed to keep out unwanted guests.
Oh, no.
After him! You may have gotten away from me this time, wall crawler, but you'll never escape me. I am Mysterio. I am your friend. You will obey my voice. Spider-Man is your enemy! Find him! Destroy him!
There! There he is! Get him!
Boy, some days it hardly pays to be a lovable superhero.
Get him!
We've got to destroy him!
I think it's time Spider-Man became good old Peter Parker for a while. Especially since Peter has a play rehearsal to study for.
No, no, it's all wrong!
Huh?
I just don't feel it. You'll have to make me believe it. Now do it again.
As president of ESU, I have a big responsibility. What you're asking me to do?
Fool! Mysterio does not ask. Mysterio demands!
Ah, shut that blasted noise off. Of course I will cooperate fully.
All right, Peter, let's try it one more time.
Somebody shut that noise off! We're in the middle of rehearsals!
Now, to create my unstoppable army, and I, Mysterio, shall be master of the world. Listen to me. I am your leader. I am Mysterio. You will obey me.
We will obey.
Fortunately, my spider nervous system isn't affected by Mysterio's hypnotic beat. And maybe I can use that.
Hear my voice and obey.
We hear! We obey!
We hear!
This is one time I might find out more as Peter Parker than I would as Spider-Man. Take me to your leader.
I am Mysterio. I am your leader. You will follow and obey.
This crowd's getting bigger and bigger. Pretty soon Mysterio will have the whole city of New York under his control. I've got to figure out a way to stop him before it's too late.
What's going on in this town? Hasn't been a decent crime all day. How am I supposed to put out a newspaper? Eh? What's this, a parade? Blasted window. Nothing works around here, including my employees. Music. I must follow. I must obey. I must obey. I must obey.
The Daily Bugle building. I wonder what old Skinflint Jameson thinks of all this. Fun and game time's over. And I'll bet Jameson will just love being rescued by Spider-Man. Suppose everyone would close their eyes while I changed into Spidey if I asked him real nice? Ah, just what the doctor ordered.
I am your master. You will follow where I lead. I am Mysterio.
My costume should be safe enough down here. Now to do what Spider-Man does best.
I must follow. I must obey.
Looks like Jameson's fallen for Mysterio's hypnotic music in a big way. Now to tuck him safely in. That should do the trick.
do they expect me to put a paper out if there's no crime? Why is it so stuffy in here? It's stuck. What numbskull is responsible for this?
At least Chuckles is back to normal. Now to put a stop to Mysterio and his nutty music machine.
I am your master. You will do as I command. On my order, you will take all the money out of the bank and give it to me. I was hoping you'd be foolish enough to try and stop me, you arrogant insect.
You've threatened me for the last time, Domehead. I don't believe it. There's no one here. It's all run by computers.
Fool! You've walked right into my trap. Well, I've got another little surprise for you, Webhead. A new disco beat I've created especially for you.
No. No. That music, it's... I must obey. I will obey.
And now you will learn the penalty for interfering with my plans. I am your master. You will obey me. Destroy Spider-Man!
We will obey. We will obey. We will obey. We must obey.
We must obey. We must destroy Spider-Man!
Aha! I have just the fitting end for our costumed clown. Listen and obey my words. Take Spider-Man into the bank, clean up the vault, and then lock the web-slinger in the vault. And now, to ensure a friendly welcome inside the bank, I'll just increase the volume of my hypnotic music.
What's taking the police so long? We can't hold off that crowd by ourselves.
This is the first city bank in New York. We need help, and fast!
I will obey. I must obey.
That music, it. We will obey. We must obey.
Mysterio orders. We must obey.
I hate to ask the obvious, but where am I? Of course, Mysterio must have hypnotized me with his far-out music, then dumped me in this vault. Fortunately, spiders don't need as much air as humans, but still, it won't be long till I suffocate in here.
What? A mob? A bank robbery? Spider-Man! This is more like it! This is one story I'll cover myself!
Once my army of followers captures a nuclear missile, who would dare oppose me?
Tumblers falling. It's like music to my ears. And speaking of music, it's time to end Mysterio's music once and for all.
What's that rabble doing up there? That music, I
will follow. I must obey.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
I haven't seen New York this empty since... Come to think of it, I've never seen New York this empty.
Mayday! 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 The missile base is under attack!
I am Mysterio. Listen and obey. Capture the nuclear missile. Destroy any who stand in our way.
I will obey. I will destroy.
Nothing. Maybe the general just dreamed it up.
Dreamed it up, did I? Look!
Now the army will march to my music.
All right, men. No matter what, we can't. That music is making me... I will obey. I must obey.
We will obey.
Open the door.
But, General, I can't open the door without the password.
You must obey. You will obey.
But, General.
You must obey. You will obey.
Well, if you say so, General. I will obey.
Nothing can stop me.
No!
Now hear this. This is your master. You must obey me. Spider-Man is on the base. Find him. Destroy him.
We will obey. We must destroy Spider-Man.
Looks like they started the party without me. But no matter.
Oh, where are we?
How'd I get here?
What am I doing here? Who are you?
Who am I? Who are you?
Spider-Man!
You're Spider-Man?
No! Whatever's going on, you can bet he's part of it.
When I get my hands on that meddlesome insect,
make it good, Jughead!
Your arrogance will be the end of you, Wall Crawler. You're on my home ground now. Perhaps you'd like a little of my spider disco music.
I prefer the Beatles to disco any day.
Give it up, Webhead! This glass booth is unbreakable.
Don't be so sure, Baldy.
No! No!
Fool! Holograms! Images created by my special effects lasers! Am I here? Or here? Or up here?
Mister, you're nowhere!
Looking for me, Webbrand? Admit it, Wallcrawler. The great Spider-Man has finally been beaten.
Maybe not, Domehead. That's a wrap.
Hmm.
Well, the show must go on.
Good night, good people.
I came all the way out here in the rain for just one line.
Oh, wasn't he wonderful?
Federation is proud to present the Saturday Crush Zone. It's a bone-busting blast of the best action on TV, with premiere episodes of Pokemon and Bakugan.
The bigger they are, the harder they fall.
A new TWF grudge match after Star Wars and Clone Wars.
This should be interesting.
And much more. When it comes to action, we're all thumbs.
That enough?
Hardly. Saturday Crush Zone. Saturday morning from 8 till noon on Cartoon Network.
Throughout the history of the passage of time, few have been able to proudly proclaim themselves as Pokemon Masters.
This President's Day, witness the latest from the greatest. It's Pokemon Diamond and Pearl Battle Dimension. Don't miss every showdown facing Ash, Pikachu, Brock, and Dawn.
Oh, right!
Show your patriotism. It's Pikachu's Day. Day. All day tomorrow, starting at 6 a.m. Right here on Cartoon Network.
The city of Townsville is now on Boomerang!
Let's go, ladies!
Yeah! Oh, goody, goody!
And so, once again, the day is saved thanks to the Powerpuff Girls! Monday through Friday at 10, only on Boomerang!
Wedgies!
Four seconds left in the game. The Chinchillas are set to kick the game-winning field goal.
$5 for cotton candy? Doggone!
The snap is good and the kick... Oh, what's this? This is fake! The Chinchillas are going for a touchdown.
Come on, man. I'll give you a dime.
Can't end in a tie.
But it can't go on without a ref.
If only there was somebody here who could fill in for the referee.
Shoot, all he needs is a striped shirt.
And a whistle.
Any kind would do, really.
Hey!
Oh, yeah, I'm over here.
I can help.
It appears that a new official has just come out of the stands and he brought his own...
Boys need a ref? I got this.
Where'd you come from?
The fans want to win it tonight, so I'm gonna do you all a favor and call the game.
Did you make that shirt yourself?
Now look here. The first team to score wins. Got it?
That's not right.
Don't test me, boy. Now let's get this wheel rolling. Y'all got a coin to toss?
Oh, for crying out loud. Sheesh.
Just hang on a second. I think I got something. Call it in the air, Stinky.
What?
Doggone it. Okay, okay. Work with me now.
Man, let's just play.
Yeah, come on. I said watch it, Stinky. You're on thin ice. Now hang on a second. Now call it in the air. Well, did you call heads or tails? Do I need to flip it again?
Cartoon Network.
This is Boomerang from Cartoon Network.
Heavens to hilarity! This is it, sports fans! Participants, even! Television's greatest array of stars! Laugh Olympics presents the round-the-world triple-team competition between the Yogi Yahooies, the Scooby Doobies, and the Really Rottens. The players are on the field, in the stadium, even! So let's get on with it! Laugh Olympics!
Hello, sports fans, and welcome to another All-Star Laugh Olympics. Today's spectacular will begin here, in mysterious but merry Midtown, Morocco. Our first event will be a rip-roaring roller scooter race through the Casbah. Then, via satellite, you'll be TV transported around the world to America the Beautiful in wonderful Washington, D.C. for an anything-goes rally race. Now it's back to Casablanca, where our reporters are waiting to get on with the action.
Ha! I don't know about you, but I'm waiting to get out before the silliness starts.
Surely you jest, Mildew. The whole world's waiting to see who will win the Laugh Olympics gold medal event. Besides, you cheat millions of viewers out of being bedazzled by your Valentino-ish face. Kisser even.
You're right, Snag. So eat your hearts out, fans, and on with the show! Same to you, fella.
Now let's meet our all-stars, the Yogi Yahooies. The Scooby Doobies. And the Really Rottens. And here are our roller scootering athletes. For the Yogis, it will be Hokey Wolf. For the Scoobies, Blue Falcon. And Daisy Mayhem for the Rottens.
Attention, you silly savages. This race route is just too ding-dongy to describe, so all I can say is, fake it!
And first to finish will win the usual 25 points. 15 for second place, and 10 for third.
And there's the go signal, so go, 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 racers! Blue Falcon has pedaled into an early lead. Daisy is tailgating in second, with no effort at all, while Hokey has slipped into last place.
No pedaling. How does she do it?
Sure, Blue Birdie. Why should I pedal? He can do my pedaling for me.
Hokey, you'll soon be out of it if you don't show more foot power.
Ooh, glad you reminded me. How's this for my foot power and in comfy comfort?
Rather hokey, hokey, but definitely faster.
Dad, gum! He could have warned me he was gonna goof up my cheek.
Things are changing, folks. The Scoobies took another route. The Rottens have stopped to take a dip, and the Yogis have moved up into second place.
This pot of couscous ought to stop that blue nit in his tracks.
I hope it stops as good as it tastes.
Uh-oh! It's a good thing I'm on my toes.
Diabolically clever. Couscous clogged wheels have rotten me out of the race.
Hey, DF!
Need a hand?
Ah, the dependable Dino-Mutt. I certainly do. Thanks a lot, Dog Blunder. But what I really need is another scooter.
You got it, Blue Buddy. A Dino Scooter Deluxe.
Blue Falcon.
And Dog Wonder away!
At the three-quarter mark, the Yogis have the lead. The Rottens are second, while the third-place Scoobies are back in the race and moving up fast.
Red to Daisy, hang a left at the alley for a cinch to win. Cheat!
Hot diggity! Cheat? All I see's a dead end.
Yes, it's a real back-and-forther, folks. The Scoobies regain the lead to put the Yogis back in second place. But it's bad luck for the Rottens. Daisy's way is blocked by a truck.
Come on, Daisy. We're going to go a-truckin' to victory.
Approaching the finish line, the Scoobies and Yogis are pedaling neck and neck, but the Rottens are nowhere in sight. So it looks like either the Scoobies or Yogis will cross first.
Better look again, Mouthy.
What's this? The Rottens just suddenly appeared from nowhere to win. And here come the Yogis and Scoobies in a tie for the second spot.
Cease! Desist! Hold it! Any win that rotten requires a replay. Instantly, Ethan.
Coming up, Snag. Ah, there's cheat number one, Daisy's invisible wire. Two, Red Baron couscousing Blue Falcon. And three, Daisy getting trucked to victory. So, Rottens, you cheated yourselves out of winning.
All I can say is that it couldn't have happened to a rottener bunch of apples.
True, Mildew. So now the scores read, it's a tie between the Yogis and Scoobies for the winning 25 points, while the Rottens are dropped back to second place for 15 points. And now, without further Mildew...
I heard that, you creep.
It's out to the desert for the Grand Moroccan Sand Chariot Race. And here are our charioteers. It's Doggy Daddy for the Yogis. Dino-Mutt is the Scoobies' entry. And for the Rottens, Red Baron.
Saffron Sirocco's Mildew. Just imagine. Ancient Romans raced chariots here. It's a real sport of heroes.
Wow. I'm not ancient, Roman, or a hero. And I think it's supercellified. Look. These dum-dums have to race to the oasis of El Drippo, then through these Roman ruins to reach the finish. In 130-degree weather, must have sun-baked beanies.
They're off! And it's a hot one, folks. The Rottens are sliding along at a scorching pace in the lead. Doggy Daddy, or is it Ben-Hur, is second, while third-place Dino-Mutt is fighting the sand.
Yup! And it's not too tasty.
Emergency instructions, Dino-Mutt.
I'm all ears, BS. All ears.
Operation High Rise. Inflate your tires.
Glad I thought of that. Going up.
Wow, the Scoobies have just bounced into second place. And another bounce should take the lead from the Rottens.
Ah, that's what you think.
Oh, too bad, Dino. Now, how will you keep up in the race?
You mean, how will I keep up in the oasis?
Red Baron, away!
The Rottens have literally flown back into first, folks. The Scoobies are second, but waterlogged, while the third-place Yogis are watering down. Pardon me, charioteers, but you can't win a race oasis-ing it.
My dear old dad can.
Thanks, my son. If you be good to camels, they'll be good to you.
And I suppose you're waiting for the oasis to evaporate, huh, Dynamut?
Nope, for my diodes to dry out.
Oh, well, the Yogis are finally on their way in first. But where's Dredd? Ah, there he is. Isn't that a rather unusual racing technique, Dredd?
It beats walking! Dynamite's self-inflating tires have an oasis him out. But if he thinks he'll catch up now, he's all wet.
Who's all wet? Mildew?
I'll tell you if I don't drown first.
Now, on the last leg of the race, the Yogis have the lead. The Scoobies are second, but the Rottens may soon overtake them both.
Attention, Rottens! Ready your traps and have a net ready to catch me!
Gotcha, Dredd.
Now, darling.
Oh, no! This could stop the Yogis.
Impossible! Nothing even slows down like Camules.
Wow, dear old dad. That's a nifty trick.
Nothing to it, one and only son of mine. I got a million of them.
Shove, Suey!
Oopsie daisy!
The Yogis are still in the lead. The Scoobies are second. But the Rottens are moving up for what could be a flying finish. Yes, here they come, folks. And the Yogis are the win. No, hold it. Dredd Bellin just sailed over into the finish banner to win for the Rottens. The Yogis are second. And the Scoobies come in third to wrap up the race. Now let's have a big hand for the winner, wherever Dredd is.
It's one thing to win, but it's another to win without cheating. Drat!
Now, checking the final halftime scores, we see the winning Rottens have shot up to tie the Yogis with 40 points each for first place, while the Scoobies are now in sole possession of second with 35.
Oh, I've had it with this sandy silliness. I'm going home.
What a coincidental, Mildew. We all are. To Washington, D.C. already. For the cataclysmically comic conclusion of today's events.
Oh, I give up. Is there no escape from this laugh of lame braininess?
No, Mildew. And sports lovers, if you think this first half was fast, fun, and action-packed, join us later for the second half of the All-Star Laugh Olympics. Hello, sports fans, and welcome back to the second half of the All-Star Laugh Olympics. We're here in the glorious capital of our nation, Washington, D.C., where our super sports are warming up for the rigorous rally race through D.C. So now let's meet our teams and their racers. It's Tinker and Speed Buggy for the Scoobies. The Yogi team and their entry, Yaki Doodle. And the Really Rottens with their star drivers, the Great Fondue and Magic Rabbit. Now our reporters will explain the event.
Our patriotic pleasure. Our racers will start here at the Washington Monument, circle the Lincoln Memorial, and then onto the Capitol building for the finish. A real Americana extravaganza, even.
Now, before proceeding, let's have a recap of the first half scores. The Yogis and Rottens are tied in first place with 40 points each, while the Scoobies have 35. So this promises to be a hotly contested event, folks. And there's the starting signal, racers. So roll on! Racing down the mall, our racers are headed out into the East Potomac Park. The Scoobies have the lead. The Yogis are second, with the Rottens, who got off to a false start, bringing up the rear.
How humiliating for the itsy ditsy ducky to beat the Great Fondue. However, I shall magic him down even itsier. Yalakazula and CPTC, reduce that duck to the size of a flea. Oops, a verbal malfunction.
Gee, at last, I grew up. Ow, watch me go.
Golly, Speedy. With Yaki 10 times bigger than us, we gotta go 10 times faster to catch him.
Okay, Tink.
Now crossing the tidal basin into the West Potomac Park, the Yogis have a giant lead. The Scoobies are second, with the Rottens last.
There's nothing like a parade to stop traffic, eh, Dad?
Yeah.
Ouch!
Golly, Yakky, it looks like we've been rotten. Let's move out.
That fast play, or rather a sneaky, by the Rottens put them in the lead. Temporarily, because the giant Yakky has just passed him to take first place, and the Scoobies are a close third as the racers reach the Lincoln Memorial.
I must speed up!
Wow, that is really fast! This is something else, folks. The Rottens are circling so fast, they can't pull out of their orbit. Meanwhile, the Scoobies have completed their lap to put them in second place.
Zappity's up! Stop! Yourself, Rabbit. My magic worked, no?
Leaping Ledger demands, Fondo. You'd better practice your magic. It's tragic, even.
Sounds your ridiculous rally racer.
True. I do need another vehicle. A better set of wheels. So, Zamity Zoomity, and pleased to behold another racer to replace the old. Ta-da!
Now, as our racers approach the Capitol building, the Yogis are maintaining a huge lead. The Scoobies are second, trying to close the gap. And, oh no! Why is a submarine racing down Pennsylvania Avenue?
Why not? Full speed ahead, Rabbit!
Rack, rack.
Golly! Can't you speed up, Speedy?
Sorry, Tink.
I guess you need a little pick-me-up. So here's a few drops of vitamin A for atomic fuel.
Not a bad trick. I shall undo that duck, Ozimity Zap on the Yogi who quacks, and Stoppity Speedy in his tracks.
Oh, no. The race was almost over, but Fondue went bananas with his magic again, folks. Now, just yards away from the finish line, Little Yakky is still first. The Scoobies are second, while the third-place Rottens seem to be sitting this one out.
Golly, Speedy! Fondue's magic shorted you out, but a push will get you started.
Let's go!
And push, Rabbit. Can I help it if I had a magical power failure?
Wow, it looks like we'll have a ducky winner.
Look again, Mildew. In that amazing burst of speed, the Scoobies have zoomed ahead to cross first. The Yogis are a close second, which naturally makes the Rottens a cinch for third place.
Black.
Checking the scores, we see that the Scoobies' win has put them on the top floor with 60 points. The Yogis are second with 55, while the Rottens have taken the elevator to the basement with 50. Well, folks, with the scores this close, we can expect a real battle as we swing over to the backyard of the Pentagon, home of the nation's Defense Department, for our next event, the U.S. Marine Corps Obstacle Course Contest. Now, let's meet our Marine Tough contestants. Boo Boo Bear for the Yogis. The Scoobies, Hong Kong Fooey. And Orful Octopus of the Rotten. And speaking of Orful, please stand by for a personal interview with his parents, Mr. and Mrs. Octopus.
Hi, folks. Everyone knows your son is a really rotten athlete. But as a young squid, kid, was he good at sports, too? Talk about parental pride. And what a loving couple. Married all these years and still holding tentacles.
There's the call to action, contestants.
So hit it! Hey!
Oh, This obstacle course is too much, Snag. Running through tires, climbing this rope netting, and swinging over a mud puddle. There's only one thing rougher than running this course, and that's reporting it.
The Rottens are approaching the first obstacle in a blur of speed. The Scoobies are a close second. But as for the Yogis, oh, too bad, Boo-Boo.
Suffering seaweed, Orful. You're not playing ring around the octopus, you know.
Well, it looks like the Rottens got tired out of first, so the Scoobies have taken their place. Uh-oh, it looks like the Scoobies and Rottens are both in trouble. Especially as the spring-loaded Yogis bounce past them to take the lead. Ah, I see the Rottens have finally sprung back in action.
Ha, the big copycats.
Now, as Boo-Boo reaches the next obstacle, Orful is rolling close behind, while Hong Kong is taking the tire course in leaps and bounds. Great! Little Boo-Boo has reached the net climb first. But, oh no! The Rottens just rolled past him to take the lead. But why has Hong Kong stopped?
Since the object is to get to the other side, why climb up? Sa! It's faster to climb through!
Yes, thanks to Hong Kong's karate, the Scoobies have shortcutted it into first place. But the Rottens are almost on top of him. Meanwhile, the Yogis are just starting down.
It's okay to make tracks, but not all over my new karate jacket.
Hey, I better bear down if I'm gonna keep up.
Seems Hong Kong is wound up with himself. Who knows what's with Orful? But look at Boo-Boo go! It's really close now, folks. Boo-Boo's halfway over. Hong Kong is swinging high. But why are the Rottens going backwards? So that's it. Orful's using the old rubber band snapback technique to sail through the finish banner and win for the Rottens. The Yogis have swung into second place just under the Scoobies, who landed in third. The Rottens' win has made them today's overall winners with 75 points, while the Yogis and Scoobies have tied for second at 70 points each. So let's hear it for our gold and silver medalists, folks.
Ooh. After this humiliating experience, I'm making tracks out of here, Snag. Those rascally Rottens muddied me into a walking mud pie.
So true, Mildew.
Ooh. Just wait till I see those Rottens again. Oh, no. On second thought, do I have to see them again?
Yes, Mildew, you do.
Oh, I was afraid you'd say that.
And all of you fans will be seeing them and our other super teams and a lot more laughs and sports action around the world when they again meet to do glorious battle to win the coveted gold medal. That includes the Rottens, too. So, see you next week for the All-Star Laugh Olympics.